Tether, also known as USDT, is one of the most popular stablecoins used around the world. It tracks the value of the US dollar, and it's increasingly used for global payments, money transfers, and as a temporary way to hold onto the value of a stable asset when you're buying or selling assets like Bitcoin or Ethereum. Unlike exchanges, you can buy Tether or USDT directly into your Zengo wallet. And unlike every other traditional crypto wallet, Zengo has no seed phrase vulnerability. What does that mean? Well, ever since Zengo was founded in 2019, with over 1 million customers to date, zero Zengo wallets have ever been hacked, taken over, or phished. That's the power of Zengo's institutional-grade MPC technology used to secure your assets. Here are the 5 steps to buy Tether with Zengo. Step number 1. Download Zengo from an official trusted source, like the Apple App Store, Google Play Store, or go to www.zengo.com, where you can reach those links there as well. Step 2, create your Zengo wallet and make sure to back it up using Zengo's Secure Recovery Kit. This ensures you can always access your wallet, even if your phone is lost or you're upgrading to a new device. For the rest of the steps, I'm going to show you real time. I have my phone right here, and I'm going to move onto the screen what you're seeing real time. So for step 3, you want to open your Zengo wallet, decide which wallet you'd like to buy USDT in. As you can see here at the top, I have my main wallet, but I also have a number of additional wallets. Any Zengo Pro customer can create up to 5 additional wallets. I'm going to be buying Tether in my main wallet today. Okay, step 4. Tap on the action button and tap on buy. Step 5. Now you need to select which asset you're going to buy. Do that either by scrolling and finding the stable coins available, or at the top you can search. And in this case, I'm going to search USDT. And you see that I have a number of options for Tether. I'm going to be buying it on Polygon today. And this will take me to my various purchasing partners. It depends on where you're located around the world. I have 4 options: MoonPay, Ramp, Banksa, and Transact. And it's worth noting that I have discounted fees enabled. Every Zengo Pro customer gets up to 50% off of purchasing fees. Today, I'm going to continue with MoonPay. And if you've never created an account with any of these partners before, you'll be taken to start the process of creating your account. It usually takes between 2 to 5 minutes. I've already created an account, so I'm just going to decide how much I want to buy. In this case, I want to buy $30 worth of USDT. I'm going to tap on continue. And now it will let me input whatever payment method I'd like to use. So instead of Apple Pay, I'm going to tap on add a payment method. And in this case, I'm going to add my credit card. So I'll start by inputting my number. I'll add the expiration date. You can see it warns here that sometimes credit cards make it less likely to succeed when purchasing crypto. You can use a debit card as well. I know that my credit card provider does allow me to purchase with crypto, but if you do run into this in the future, the best bet is to actually call your credit card provider, let them know what you're doing, and usually they won't stop it the next time you try to approve a transaction. Tap on continue. All you need to do is review one last time. Make sure that it's the credit card you'd like to use. You'll see the address that you'll be sending the USDT to. And then finally, you tap pay to confirm. And that's how you buy USDT with Zengo using a credit card.